There are planets in the universe which go beyond all of our imaginations. Some are so insanely hot that they are hotter than stars. Others have weird precipitation in the form of glass and iron. Up until relatively recently, these descriptions were only figments of our imaginations until the 6th of October 1995, when two astronomers made a groundbreaking discovery that shook the astronomy world to its core. What they discovered was a planet that orbits very near its host star, but also has a mass very similar to Jupiter, about half its mass. This came as a shock to many, because before then, the only gas planets we had known were our own, and they were cold and orbit far away from the Sun. However, in the years following 1995, planets like this were being discovered at an alarming rate, suggesting that the galaxy is teeming with them. This class of planets is named hot Jupiters, and they orbit extremely close to their stars, with scorching conditions. Today we will explore these mysteriously common planets in terms of how they could have formed, the insanely brutal conditions, and the unique atmospheres they hold. The term hot Jupiter comes from the fact that these planets have masses similar to Jupiter and experience very hot temperatures. These are among the largest planets in the galaxy, and many of them are so big that they start to blur the lines between a planet and a star. Scientists believe that planets larger than about 16 times the mass of Jupiter are capable of deuterium fusion, which classifies them as brown dwarfs rather than planets. Another characteristic of hot Jupiters is their close proximity to their stars. To understand this better, let's take one example of a hot Jupiter, HD 189733b, located 64 light-years away, the closest one to Earth. Comparing its orbit to Mercury, Mercury orbits the Sun in about 88 Earth days. HD 189733b does so in only 53 hours, or just over 2 Earth days, and this is part of why these discoveries were initially so shocking to scientists. It's worth considering the temperatures on these planets as well. Mercury, at the distance it orbits the Sun, has surface temperatures that exceed 400 degrees Celsius. With HD 189733b, as close as it orbits its star, has cloud temperatures that exceed 800 degrees Celsius. As a result of their proximity to their stars, they tend to be tidally locked. This means that one side of the planet always faces the star, while the other side is in complete darkness. Depending on the weather conditions specific to the planet, this can mean that the night side is either cold due to lack of starlight, or it might still be very hot due to planetary winds. Hot Jupiters are usually discovered by transiting, that is, observing a star and watching for periodic dips in its brightness due to a possible planet that passes in front. Because these planets orbit very quickly and close to their stars, their atmospheres can be analyzed very reliably using starlight that passes through their atmospheres. With the help of Spitzer Space Telescope, James Webb, and Hubble, and many ground telescopes, astronomers have found exotic compositions that are unlike anything seen in the solar system, and we'll explore these later in the video. Given the unusual nature of hot Jupiters, a difficult problem among astronomers has been to try and figure out how these hot Jupiters could have formed. Several hypotheses have been performed to try and explain how these massive planets end up so close to their stars. The most popular explanation is the migration hypothesis. This hypothesis says that hot Jupiters initially form and accrete matter at large distances from their young stars. This is where ice, gas, and rocks exist for the planet to take form. They slowly migrate closer to their stars over a period of millions of years. The migration is thought to be caused by the planet interacting with the gas and dust present around its then young star. Corroborating this hypothesis, astronomers might have already observed a prime example of a migrating hot Jupiter. In 2016, the Spitzer Space Telescope made observations of an intriguing hot Jupiter, HD 80606b. This planet has a very unusual orbit around its star, being very eccentric. This goes against the common model of orbital behavior of hot Jupiters, which tend to be extremely circular. It also has an orbital period of around 111 days, which is the longest of any transiting exoplanet. Because of its highly eccentric orbit, its temperature increases several hundreds of degrees in a matter of only 6 hours. Given these facts, astronomers believe that HD 80606b was caught in the act of migrating towards a stable close orbit. However, there is some conflicting data concerning when these hot Jupiters actually undergo migration. This was caused by the discovery of planet HIP67522b, the youngest hot Jupiter ever discovered, at only 17 million years old. The planet is less than 2% the age of other known hot Jupiters, yet it has already established for itself a very close and stable orbit around its star. Although the migration hypothesis is favored by astronomers, it is not without its issues, and the formation of these planets is an area of ongoing research. Hot Jupiters have the most extreme and brutal atmospheric conditions we've ever seen, far surpassing the extreme conditions present within our solar system. We've already seen how brutal HD189733b's conditions are, and this is only one of many examples of extreme hot Jupiters that exists. We'll first take a look at an exoplanet which absolutely pushes the boundaries for how hot a planet can get. KELT-9b, discovered relatively recently in 2016, is a hot Jupiter that orbits a young, hot star. The planet has temperatures that exceed 4,000 degrees Celsius. Let's take a moment to understand just how ridiculously hot this is. If we look at the periodic table of elements, we can see that at 4,000 degrees Celsius, almost all of the elements are in the gaseous form. Here's something else to consider. Different types of stars burn at different temperatures, as indicated by their colors. Blue stars are extremely hot and burn at over 10,000 degrees Celsius. A yellow star like our sun burns at over 5,500 degrees Celsius. However, red dwarf stars, the coolest types of stars, burn at no more than 3,000 degrees Celsius. Furthermore, red dwarf stars are the most common types in the universe. Therefore, it would be scientifically accurate to say that KELT-9b is not only hotter than many stars, but is actually hotter than most stars in the universe. You might be thinking about why this planet isn't a star, since it's hotter than most of them. The reason is because it simply doesn't have enough mass to sustain its own nuclear fusion, being about only twice as massive as planet Jupiter. While hot Jupiters have extreme temperatures like KELT-9b, they are also known to have spectacular precipitation and complicated exotic atmospheres. An example of one of these planets is WASP-76b, which orbits a main sequence star. This planet is also extremely hot, with an equilibrium temperature of about 2,000 degrees Celsius. According to data from the Hubble Space Telescope and the Spitzer Space Telescope, WASP-76b's atmosphere contains titanium oxide and water, along with several metals such as ionized lithium, sodium, magnesium, calcium, manganese, potassium, barium, and iron. Considering that the planet is so hot, most of these metals would exist in the gaseous form throughout the planet, with daytime temperatures reaching 2400 degrees Celsius and a nighttime temperature of about 1400 degrees Celsius. The night side is theoretically cool enough for neutral iron to condense into its liquid form and fall as rain, and some models have suggested that this is what actually happens on this planet. As we've seen, hot Jupiters are among the hottest types of exoplanets that we know exist. They are also the largest, many of them being more massive than Jupiter. This might lead to the question, what's the difference between a very massive planet and a small star? Especially considering that planets when KELT-9b have surface temperatures that are hotter than most stars. Since the advent of exoplanetary science, astronomers have actually discovered hundreds of objects that blur the line between a planet and a star. What they found is that once a body exceeds 13 Jupiter masses, it starts to take on stellar characteristics while still maintaining a planetary structure. More specifically, the thermonuclear fusion of deuterium is able to take place beyond this mass. This is the definition of a brown dwarf. Simply put, brown dwarfs are objects that did not gain enough mass to sustain themselves as stars. it isn't until beyond 80 Jupiter masses that we get into the realm of true stars. How Jupiters are only one of possibly hundreds of classes of exoplanets that we know exist in our galaxy. As technology continues to improve, and as we develop new methods to study these planets, we will continue to make groundbreaking discoveries. Hot Jupiters will continue to be the easiest class of planets to study, and I'm confident that the future of studying these planets is bright.